Today I want to talk about something a bit unusual that was discovered a little while ago. It's got a funny name. It's called Hanny's Voorwerp. I may be pronouncing that completely wrong. Any of our Dutch viewers can correct me. This is an object that was discovered by accident, as many of the most exciting astronomical discoveries are made. And it was actually discovered by a member of the public, a school teacher in Holland named Hanny van Arkel. And so the name is Hanny's Voorwerp, and Voorwerp, I understand, means Dutch for object. So this is Hanny's object, and that's what it looks like. It's a bit of a funny looking thing. So one of the things that we do as astronomers is we take pictures. It's one of the most basic things that we can do. And even now, even when we have digital images from great big telescopes, we still get a lot of information by looking at them with our eye. So a typical thing for an astronomer like myself to do would be to cycle through maybe hundreds or even thousands of images of individual objects. So this is from my own survey. So these are images from the Hubble Space Telescope. Here's a beautiful galaxy that we're seeing. It's a disk, like our own Milky Way, but we're seeing it edge on. And we'll see a huge variety of different kinds of objects, great big round ones, things with spiral arms, things that we might call that a train wreck, you know, it might be the collision of two galaxies, something that's been really disruptive. So even though we have automated routines to gather some of this information, we can teach a computer to do this. Those automated routines are still not perfect, and there's still a lot to be gained by using our eye-brain system, which is really good at picking out particular patterns or particular features. So in my own research, I may have gone through probably about 4,000 or 5,000 of these images, recording whether they have spiral arms, whether they're round, whether they have bars, whether they're all messed up, together with a team of maybe about 7 or 8 other people, we could cover, in my survey, about 6,000 or 7,000 galaxies, with each one being done a couple of times to make sure that we agree on our classification. But what about when you have a survey like the Sloan Digital Sky Survey, where you actually have millions of galaxies? And that's far too many galaxies for any sane individual to look through one by one. So in this case, a project called Galaxy Zoo has enlisted members of the public to help with this project. Now, Galaxy Zoo is a project that I'm not involved with, but is close to our hearts here in Nottingham because our collaborator, our colleague Stephen Bamford down the hall, plays a key role in this project. And they've enlisted literally hundreds of thousands of people, members of the general public, school children, amateur astronomers, people off the street to help.
And me.
And Brady, of course,
yeah.
To help with this problem. How many galaxies have you looked at, Brady?
I did about 20.
Oh, I don't think you're up there in the top. And this is the Galaxy Zoo webpage at galaxyzoo.org. So a Galaxy Zoo participant, once they register and log in, they do the same thing. They are presented with pictures of galaxies, and they look at them, and they're asked a very specific set of questions or criteria to really narrow down the focus of the science. And all of those classifications are combined in a very clever statistical way, and the project has shown that these classifications are as robust as the classifications of done by professional astronomers like ourselves. And in the first leg of the project, as I said, they had 150,000 people classifying 1 million galaxies, submitting 50 million classifications. I couldn't speak for all of them, but a lot of it is you get a real hands-on connection with the actual science, with the images. The images themselves are beautiful. You're looking at spectacular pictures of galaxies, collections of hundreds of billions of stars, billions and billions of light years away. And then there's always this seed, this possibility that you're going to uncover something that nobody else has. And that's exactly what happened in the case of Hanny's Voorwerp. So Hanny van Arkel, the school teacher from Holland, was a participant in the Galaxy Zoo project, and she uncovered this strange object. I think she posted on the Galaxy Zoo forums to ask if anyone else knew what this was. No one could explain it. And it became an object of interest. It became something out of the ordinary, something unexpected. And that's always what we like to go and follow up. So what you're seeing here is lots of galaxies. There's this one big galaxy here, which you can see has hints of spiral arms. There's another companion galaxy next to it. But what we're interested in is this green object here, and this is Hanny's Voorwerp. So it's an irregular shape that already tells us there's something strange about this object. And in the color scheme that we are shown here, it's bright green. So it's very different in color from any of the other galaxies around it. And that means it's emitting light at a particular frequency and at a particularly narrow frequency. So, as I said, this was a puzzle. It wasn't immediately obvious what this object was. Members of the Galaxy Zoo Project and other astronomers around the world have since followed it up with many different telescopes at different wavelengths, trying to find out as much as they could about it. What they've determined is that it doesn't have any stars of its own. It's mostly gas and dust. It's probably the remnants of a little tiny galaxy that's been tidally pulled apart by interacting gravitationally with this much larger galaxy. But we might not normally see that because the gas or the dust in the absence of stars, wouldn't be very bright. What they think has happened is that something has dumped a lot of energy into this gas. It's ionized it and it's made it glow at this particular narrow wavelength. That object could be something like a quasar, so a supermassive black hole accreting material and spewing out tons and tons of energy. But there's no smoking gun in this picture. At any wavelengths, they can't actually see the candidate quasar. It may be very, very hidden. It may be hidden in the center of this galaxy here. But another possibility, which is very intriguing, is that it was spewing out all this energy, but stopped. And we've had enough time for that energy to reach Hanny's Voorwerp, ionize that gas, and make it glow. But that gap could be as long as 100,000 years. So what we could be seeing here is what's called a light echo of a quasar that's now dormant, it's now dead, but we can still see what kind of effects it's had on these objects around it.